Grasshopper clock update. Hey guys, Jacques here. Wanted to talk a little bit more about my Grasshopper clock and especially how you get it started the first time. Let's take it off the wall and go into some details. So I took off this back brace that holds the clock to the wall. And here's the clock. Here's the backside of the clock. One thing we want to make sure is the distance between that pin to the center of the escape pivot. And it's 175, I believe. So you want this distance between the middle here to that notch to be equal to the distance on the crutch. Next, you want to make sure this is centered with the frame. That's going to make it much easier when you go to hook it up to the wall. And you can adjust this by moving those nuts a little bit right or left to balance the anchor. Now, some setup for the escapement. So, first thing, since I have a maintained spring, I'm going to put some tension on the maintained spring. Here, the ratchet. So I can turn the ratchet here to tighten up the maintained spring. Now I can test the anchor if it's working. What you want to check is the pallet, that it hooks up the escape wheel well centered. So this is the entry pallet, and when it comes down, just engage all the way in the escape wheel. And then when you go to the other side, that it disengage well. Same for the exit pallet on the other side. Engage there. And the clock is running on the maintain spring. This you can fine tune with the nut that's behind this bolt. By doing the nut a little bit bigger or smaller, you can adjust the height where the pallet is going to engage on the escape wheel. You want the pallet to disengage well. That's why I put that bolt here to give a little bit more weight so it pops out, but not too much. Same on the other side, a bolt on this end. So that's running the clock on the maintained spring is a good way to make a first test on the bench. Because there's one thing. There is a point when the anchor is in the middle, it doesn't really engage well with the escape wheel. And if you put some weight when it's not set up right, you end up with a escape wheel runaway and you might break some of the teeth. You see here. So that's not something you want. So when those tests are good, we can now put the clock back onto the wall. So remember that pin here needs to go in that slot. Then I can put my back brace back. Then I can check that the pendulum is in the middle of that brace. That also shows the angle of swing right and left. Then put the screws for the brace. Now again, I'm going to put some tension on the maintained spring, and I'm going to take the pendulum and see how far I'll go when I hear it click. It's going further this way. You can also use a level to check it out. So when you're ready with all this to put the weight, have the string long enough so the weight can sit on the floor or sit on the box or something. So hook up the string, then you can take your rewind key, put it in place, start putting some tension. But before you put tension on the string, make sure you have one of the pallets that's well engaged in the escape wheel. And now you can put some weight on the string. Okay, now the weight is pulling the string. I'm going to take the bob of the pendulum, pull it to one side, make sure it's still clicking by pushing back and forth. Okay, I'm going to pull it, and when this pallet releases, I can just let go of the bob. And that was not enough, so a little bit more. And the clock is ticking. Now that it's clicking, I'm going to check the swing angle again. I'm going also to watch how much recoil I have on the exit and the entry. I have more on the entry. The escapement is not totally symmetrical, and so always notice there's more recoil on the entry side than the exit side when I have balanced angles here. I don't know if it's too much play or this is closer to the center than this point. Just find the position that seems to be working well. No absolute answer, no absolute solution here. Only one thing I would say, you want to make sure you have recoil on both sides. Recoil is when the composer is lifted off from the anchor. This is pretty good. So I can take my screwdriver and tighten those two screws. So now my clock is pretty steady to the wall. I can take my rewind key again. Mm-hmm. Okay, now my clock is ready to run for over 24 hours. Because 28, 29 hours with the distance I have from the clock to the floor. So far it's been running really steady. I had less than a minute over a week of runtime, less of a 1 minute drift, so it's pretty good. The way I do at the beginning to adjust the length of the pendulum is I'm going to catch the pendulum when it's one side, then I can adjust the knot up or down, up to go faster, down to go slower, and then I can just let it go. When I have less, once I have less than a minute variation per 24 hours after adjusting the bottom screw, now I can come and do some fine tuning at the top, and the top screw, I don't need to stop the clock to adjust, so I can just do little increment, just do a little bit at a time and then let it go for 24 hours and check it again. I'm really happy how the Grasshopper Escapement clock is working, and quite intrigued of how much better I can get this to work. So stay tuned, please like, subscribe, and I'll see you in next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.